Morning devotion for January 4th, Monday, January 4th, 2021. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O Lord, teach us your ways, that we may walk in your truth. You comfort and help us day by day. We trust your loving care. You are the King of heaven and earth. We give you praise and thanks. Alleluia. We pray. Lord Jesus, you invite us to pray and promise that where two or three come together in your name, there you are with us. Answer our prayers and fulfill our desires according to your wisdom and love. Strengthen us in the knowledge of your truth and grant us life everlasting. Amen. A reading from John chapter 8, verses 12 through 20. Again, Jesus spoke to them, saying, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. So the Pharisees said to him, You are bearing witness about yourself. Your testimony is not true. Jesus answered, Even if I do bear witness about myself, my testimony is true. For I know where I came from and where I am going. But you do not know where I come from or where I am going. You judge according to the flesh. I judge no one. Yet even if I do judge, my judgment is true. For it is not I alone who judge, but I and the Father who sent me. In your law it is written that the testimony of two people is true. I am the one who bears witness about myself, and the Father who sent me bears witness about me. They said to him, therefore, Where is your Father? Jesus answered, You know neither me nor my Father. If you knew me, you would know my Father also. These words he spoke in the treasury as he talked in the temple, but no one arrested him because his hour had not yet come. The Gospel of our Lord. And we confess our Christian faith with the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Our reading today taken from the Gospel of John chapter 8. As we this week close out a Christmas season in the church year and begin the Epiphany season of the church year. A beautiful time of the year as we recognize a new year coming, a new year happening, and in the comfort we have of the Christmas truth that Jesus came, God in flesh, to be the light of the world, to be the light of the world. And that's what Jesus testifies about himself before the Jews in John chapter 8, that he is that light. I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. We recognize the focus of Christmas and Epiphany, right? Jesus is a light not just for the Jews, but for the Gentiles as well. And the place of light is needed to have life. Without it, it leads to death. Without light, there's only death and darkness then. And you think of this time of year as well, often can be gloomy and dark and cloudy, and we miss that beautiful sunlight. So here we have Jesus proclaiming, I am the light of the world. We don't walk in darkness, but have the light of life. It does seem dark many times in our lives. It can be very dark, and we think of the darkness of our sin and what that leads to. Yet God declares us, he tells us, that he makes us his light because of Jesus, and that's what we are. We are those who are in the light by faith in Jesus Christ, and that gives us the confidence and the peace of sins forgiven. That gives us the confidence and peace no matter how deep the darkness is here. We have the light. We have the true light that gives us life eternal in our Savior Jesus. And that connects us, as he went on in John 8 there with the Pharisees, it connects us to the comfort we can have of the Father and the Son, connected in the Godhead, yet distinct persons. And they who didn't know it, right? They didn't know Jesus, where he was going and where he was coming, because they didn't know the Father. And just consider that today, of wherever you are, as you hear this or watch this, one who knows the Son and therefore knows the Father. That's a gift from God today. Every day, that's a gift from God to know and believe in Jesus as your Savior, to believe in Jesus as that light that shines in the darkness of this world, to give us forgiveness of sins, to give us eternal life. And because of that, we have cause and reason to rejoice. I know as we enter into a new year, people are looking forward to lots of things, and that's good too, and lots of changes, and that's good too. And we do those things not with just a hopeful wish, and it, maybe it'll go better, maybe it won't, but we go in there with confidence that even if things don't change as we want them to, and so drastically, whatever it is, we walk in the light as his children, not in the darkness of unbelief, but in the light of faith in Jesus Christ. May that continue to be your comfort today and always as we continue to walk through that this week, seeing Jesus as that light to all nations. Continue with our intercession, prayer responses. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all people throughout the world, to strengthen believers and to enlighten unbelievers, we pray. Lord, have mercy. For peace and justice among nations, for honest leaders and good neighbors, for the gift of love, for steadfast faith and patient endurance, we pray. Lord, have mercy. For those who suffer pain or sorrow, for the lonely and depressed, for the poor and needy, for those who love us and those who hate us, we pray. Lord, have mercy. Be gracious to us, defend us by your power, and bring us to glory everlasting. To you, O Lord, we entrust ourselves. Amen. You have taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The almighty and merciful Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless and preserve us. Amen. Blessed day.